three of the directions. The topic is comparing rates of change in both linear and exponential situations. Boldface letter. Identify whether situation A or situation B has the greater rate of change. So what you notice about each of these situations is that they're modeling a particular situation. And one situation is modeled using a table of values, X and Y, that's situation A. The other situation is modeling the data using a graph. In order to have a proper comparison, we would have to argue that both of these situations are either both linear or both exponential to compare rates of change. So typically when you compare rates of change, you want to compare two linear situations to one another and see which has the greatest rate of change. Or compare two exponential situations and see which has the greatest rate of change. So I'm under the assumption here that both of these are linear. But I want to make sure. So is it possible to take the table of values and model that situation with a graph? Like situation B is. It's a graph. A linear graph. And you can't. And I've said this many, many times. GeoGebra is the best way to graph, especially if you have access to a computer, a Chromebook, an iPad. So here's the graph of situation A. I'm taking negative 10, negative 48, and all the other table values, and writing them as ordered pairs and graphing them. And then I'm also going to graph situation B on GeoGebra to see how it compares to situation A as a graph. Now, the only thing I need to know, though, is for situation B, this point has a coordinate of 0, negative 3, the y-intercept. And this point here has a coordinate of 1, comma 3. So I'll take those two points, plot them, and then connect them using the line function. And so here's what we have. That is the graph of situation A and situation B. I will annotate here. This is line B. And I can change the color as well. There you go. And so the darker line would be line A. Now, just by using mere observation, which line appears to be steeper or have the greatest rate of change? If you said line B, you're correct. Line B is situation B, and line A is situation A. Notice that the table of values, negative 7, negative 33, negative 8, negative 38, negative 9, negative 43, negative 10, negative 48, those were written in a table form. It was modeled differently. But again, enter those into GeoGebra and you can plot the line and easily see that B has the greatest rate of change. Now, how would I use the information without graphing? Well, you use something called the slope and describe the situation using the change in y over the change in x. The rate of change for linear functions is called the slope. So which has the greatest value? So since we have graphs here, we can visually inspect what the slope is. And I'll do that here. So I'm going to go up so many units. It's called the rise. Over one unit. And that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Up 6 over 1, and that's the slope. Using the visual inspection. Here I don't have that luxury, so what I'll use is our traditional formula, the change in y over the change in x. And that formula says that you take your a y coordinate from your first point and subtract the second y coordinate from the first. Take your x coordinate for the run, the first point, subtract the second x coordinate from the first. And since we have a table of values, what I'd like to do is just take, why not just take negative 48 and subtract negative 43? That would be my change in y. So I'll do that. And it's negative 48 minus negative 43. And so the difference there is positive, or actually negative 5, right? Yeah. And you can see that you're adding negative 5 here, right? We've done that before, right? That technique of showing that pattern, arithmetic sequence. So let's look at our x values, the change there. And so that would be negative 10. Now remember, negative 48, which x coordinate corresponds with negative 48? It's negative 10. That's why you subtract in this order. Minus negative 9. Answer is negative 1. And again, you can see that this interval size, you're adding negative 1 each time, so that they have equal intervals. And that is our slope here. It is negative 5 over negative 1, which is positive 5 over 1, or just 5, right? And so what's larger, 5 or 6? 6 is larger. So you can see that the greatest slope is 6. So situation B has the greatest rate of change. I hope that helps. Like I always say, study hard, learn a lot. We will see you soon. Bye-bye.